Six men have been charged in connection to that brutal attack caught on camera. The NYPD is still looking for more suspects.
And I continue to believe that as a former police officer. We have a job of to apprehend those who commit crimes.
I don't see an ending to this. This issue will destroy New York City.
In 2023, we saw a decrease in subway crimes. January was the first month that you saw an uptick.
Police also telling us that one of the individuals who was arrested is a 24-year-old man by the name of Yorman Reverend.
Think they're going to commit a crime in this city? That's not acceptable. And that is what we're seeing.
Brawl between migrants and police. There's been a political uproar and revived discussion about a long-standing New York City policy that restricts collaboration between local law enforcement and federal immigration authorities following the release of a video depicting a group of migrants fighting with police in Times Square. The men are seen kicking police officers on the sidewalk and attempting to rip them off of a man who the police had placed on the ground in the surveillance film, which was obtained on January 27th outside a homeless shelter in Manhattan. In relation to the attack, police have detained 7 people. However, prosecutors have dismissed charges against one person who they believe may not have been involved. Although there were no major injuries, the footage of the cops being beaten has angered many people. After the number of individuals detained were released from custody pending trial, some of that rage has been directed on prosecutors and the legal system. With the tens of thousands of asylum seekers the city has housed in shelters and motels over the past year, New York City officials have been using more and more ominous rhetoric. Immigration advocates claim that some of the remarks are inciting hatred due to the conduct of a few bad apples, which has shocked them. A Venezuelan man wanted in a string of cell phone robberies, Police Commissioner Edward Caban stated at a news conference on Monday, "A wave of migrant crime has washed over our city." He called the accomplices of the suspect ghost criminals, saying that they had no social media, no pictures, and no criminal background when they arrived in New York. On Monday morning, the NYPD published a video that showed Mayor Eric Adams accompanying officers during a raid of a Bronx apartment complex related to that inquiry. An officer warned of migrants preying on vulnerable New Yorkers, and menacing music played while video of a lady being dragged behind a scooter during a purse robbery was shown. When asked for evidence to support the allegation of a crime wave, police and city authorities said that they were unable to do so because the city doesn't keep track of trends in crime based on the nationality of suspects. Since the start of the migrant immigration spike 18 months ago, most categories of crime have decreased. The mayor and the NYPD, according to Alexa Aviles, head of the City Council's Immigration Committee, are engaging in the same old Trumpian fear-mongering and the systemic scapegoating of a diverse and vulnerable group of people. "I thought there was less crime," Aviles continued. "Where's the proof that these claims are true?"
6 men have been charged in connection to that brutal attack caught on camera. The NYPD is still looking for more suspects.
Those who commit serious crimes in the city, they should be able to be deported after they serve their time.
The question, why did these 4 individuals be released on their own recognizance?
Out to the public as well as pictures of the suspects, which they believe led to additional arrests.
Think they're going to commit a crime in this city? That's not acceptable. And that is what we're seeing.
Democratic policies at City Hall have made this much more difficult for our law enforcement than it needs to be.
Adams stated that the great majority of the approximately 175,000 migrants are law-abiding during press appearances on Monday. And any New Yorker would be wrong to look at people trying to fulfill the next step on the American dream as criminals, he said. However, Adams also demonstrated a willingness to back down from a series of regulations that frequently prevent the city from assisting federal efforts to enforce immigration laws in recent days. The moderate Democrat and former police captain Adams referred to the Times Square incident as an attack on the foundation of our symbol of safety and urged the city council to think about whether there should be more collaboration with federal immigration agents. He didn't go into detail. Since 2014, unless an individual has been found guilty of a specific violent crime and a court has issued a warrant for their deportation, the police department and municipal jails are not permitted to hold persons in custody on behalf of U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement. There's no presence of federal immigration authorities within the city's correctional system. It's not authorized for the city to provide resources to aid in the detention and deportation procedure. It was unclear at first, according to expert, what impact, if any, the city's alleged sanctuary policy may have had on the cases of the individuals who are alleged to have attacked police in Times Square. When asked by email if they intended to detain the participants in the altercation, an ICE representative didn't reply. The release of 5 out of the 6 suspects who were detained has infuriated police authorities. Nonetheless, prosecutors' and courts' decisions regarding bail are independent of the city's immigration laws.
The problem that ICE has is that because the NYPD is prohibited from sharing information.
Officers that were attacked, they did have minor injuries, I should say, and they were treated at the scene.
And I continue to believe that as a former police officer. We have the job of to apprehend those who commit crimes.
Pushing a bill that would force local law enforcement agencies to report to federal authorities every time that a migrant is arrested.
Our criminal justice system is upside down. It fails every day.
Alvin Bragg, the district attorney from Manhattan, responded to criticism from the public by saying that his office was still working to make sure that all of the individuals were correctly recognized. According to a Bragg representative, one of the men who was detained was not charged due to inadequate evidence of his involvement. He predicted that more attackers would be taken into custody in the next few days. Beginning on Tuesday, prosecutors will present evidence to a grand jury. The city's sanctuary laws, according to their supporters, increase public safety by assuring immigrant communities don't fear dealing with the legal system as witnesses or possible victims of crime in addition to being criminal defendants. Up to 3,000 persons were detained in New York City a decade ago in order to assist federal immigration authorities in starting detention and deportation procedures. Immigration authorities stated that in certain instances, police would notify federal officials right once upon an arrest, even before a conviction was obtained. Kenneth Giannullo, the director of ICE's field office in New York, stated that it was more difficult to deport criminals because of the city's lack of cooperation during a press conference on Monday that was attended by conservative elected officials. "They stopped contacting us," he declared. "Hundreds of people are being arrested all over the city, and unfortunately, the media will be the only source of information if we're unable to identify which ones are the most violent." Executive Director of the Immigration Coalition, Murad Awada, issued a warning stating that the mayor's remarks regarding removing sanctuary protections may send a shiver down the spine of the city's over 500,000 undocumented immigrants. "Why are they stoking the fire right now?" said Awada. It appears that he's attempting to divert attention from the more pressing problems, which include his current poor administration of the city. Navigating security challenges. In recent developments, Eric Adams, the city official, has brought attention to pressing issues surrounding a migrant camp on Randall's Island. The proposal for a curfew in response to an attack on a security guard is a significant move, indicating a need for heightened security measures. Simultaneously, Adam hints at a change at the city's sanctuary status, suggesting a reevaluation of policies in the face of a perceived migrant crime wave. The announcement of a curfew on Randall's Island highlights the urgency of addressing security concerns within the migrant camp. While specific details about the attack on the security guard are not provided, the proposal suggests that recent incidents have raised alarms about the overall safety within the camp. A curfew, often a measure reserved for times of heightened risk or emergency, reflects a proactive approach to maintaining order and protecting both residents and migrants in the area. Furthermore, the mention of a migrant crime wave draws attention to a broader issue that extends beyond the isolated incident on Randall's Island.
Complex legal process in just a matter of days. Now there's a fear looming that the man involved with that attack could avoid being brought to justice.
Horrific attack, and it was all caught on camera. Police ultimately put the surveillance video of that attack.
Thousands of migrants that have made their way into this country have come to New York, putting a strain on some of the city services.
I don't see an ending to this. This issue will destroy New York City.
Visual is for both the DA's office and the mayor to be able to say that New York is on top of.
The term implies a significant increase in criminal activities involving migrants. This surge may encompass various offenses, prompting city officials to consider policy adjustments to better address and curtail such criminal behavior. The proposed change in the city's sanctuary status indicates a shift in the approach towards migrants. Sanctuary policies, traditionally designed to provide a safe haven for individuals regardless of immigration status, are being reconsidered in light of the perceived connection to rising crime. This policy shift reflects a desire to strike a balance between compassion and public safety, acknowledging the importance of protecting the community while still recognizing the rights of migrants. The specific mention of the slaying of Georgia nursing student Laken Riley adds a poignant layer to the discussion. The accused killer, a Venezuelan national who entered the U.S. illegally in 2022, was arrested in New York City but was released before ICE could issue a detainer. This case underscores potential shortcomings in the immigration enforcement process, sparking concerns about the effectiveness of current protocols in preventing crimes committed by individuals with questionable immigration status. In conclusion, the proposed curfew, potential changes in sanctuary policies, and the specific case of Laken Riley slaying collectively paint a complex picture of security challenges faced by cities grappling with the intersection of migration and criminal activities. As officials navigate these complexities, finding a balance between maintaining public order and upholding the principles of sanctuary will be crucial for fostering a secure and inclusive community. The evolving situation on Randall's Island serves as a microcosm, prompting a broader conversation about the need for comprehensive immigration and security measures to safeguard both residents and migrants alike.
In 2023, we saw a decrease in subway crimes. January was the first month that you saw an uptick.
They brutally attacked a New York City police officer and a lieutenant.
Has hurt us. And where the White House needs to make adjustments.
Police also telling us that one of the individuals who was arrested is a 24-year-old man by the name of Yorman Reverend.
Around in so many different sectors is how do we solve the problem? 177,000 migrants and asylum seekers.
That's going to do it for this video. See you guys next time and bye for now.